Hi everyone, welcome to Control System Lecture Series. This is lecture number 6. In the previous lecture, we tried to cover the SFG concepts and also its applications. Now in this lecture onwards, we will see the previous paper questions which will be solved easily by using SFG concept. First, we will recollect the Mason's gain formula which we already discussed in the previous lecture. This is the Mason's gain formula. Transfer function. Mason's gain formula is mainly used to find out the transfer function of the given system. The given system may be represented in block diagram or it may be represented in signal flow graph. Then the transfer function C of S by R of S is nothing but summation of K, Tk, delta K by delta, where K is nothing but the number of forward paths, Tk is nothing but the kth forward path gain, whereas delta is nothing but 1 minus sum of all loop gains plus sum of two non-touching loop gains minus sum of three non-touching loop gains plus so on, whereas delta K is nothing but 1 minus loop gains which does not touch the kth forward path, which does not touch the kth forward path. So this is the transfer function formula. By using Mason's gain formula, you can easily find out the transfer function of the given system. Now I'll try to analyze the previous paper questions based upon this concept. Let's start our discussion with previous paper questions. This is the first question from PGSET ECE 2015 paper. What we need to find out is the ratio of V of S by I of S in the signal flow graph. That means we need to find out the transfer function for a given SFG. Before starting Mason's gain application, first we need to identify the number of forward paths in the given SFG. That is the basic definition of forward path. A signal starts from input node and reaches to the output node without repeating any other nodes by tracing the path. That is the basic definition. That means given SFG has only one forward path which starts from I of S and reaches to V of S without repeating any nodes. For example, if you consider the upper portion as a forward path, it has the repeated node because the loop starts from the same junction and again ends at the same junction. So the path which starts from I of S to junction and again goes to upper path and again reaches to the same node. So this path is not considered as a forward path because there is a repetition of node here. Similarly, the downward path is also not considered as a forward path because the same node is repeating here. That's why in the given SFG, we have only one forward path. What is the gain value? Gain value is 1 here. There is no mention of any gain value or theorem, that means you should consider it as a unity gain. So in the given SFG, T1 value, that is the gain value of first forward path, is 1. What about the number of loops here? It has self loops, two self loops, L1 and L2, with a gain value minus S, and another loop has a gain value minus 1 by S. What is the Mason's gain formula now? We have only one forward path, that is K value is 1. The formula will be T1 delta 1 by delta. So P1 is nothing but gain value 1 here. What about the delta 1? Delta 1 is nothing but we need to identify the loop which is not touching in the first forward path. That loop gain we should subtract from 1. Delta 1 is nothing but 1 minus the loop gain which is not touching in the first forward path. But in the question, all the loops are touching in the first forward path only. This is the first forward path. Both L1 and L2, both the loops are touching the first forward path. There is no possible of any non-touching loop in the first forward path. That's why delta 1 value is also 1 here. E1 is already known, the gain value is 1, delta 1 value is 1. What about the delta? Delta is nothing but 1 minus sum of all loops. Sum of all loops means you should add all the possible loops in the SFG. Because both the loops are touching, there is no other summing points will occur. There is no other possible of two non-touching and three non-touching loops in the given SFG. Because the given loops are all touching loops, so only you should consider 1 minus sum of all loops. So 1 minus sum of all loop gains. You should add these loop gains and subtract from 1. Okay, so this is the basic identification from the given SFG. So if we simplify these with Mason's gain formula substitution values, then we will get the given answers. Okay, we will see clearly the solution. This is the solution for this. So we already discussed that given SFG has only one forward path which travels from A to C through B node. So P1 is nothing but 1. Delta 1 is nothing but 1 because all the loops are touching the first forward path only. Both the L1 L2 will touch in the forward path. That's why delta 1 value is 1. And what about the gain values of L1 and L2? L1 is minus S, L2 is minus 1 by S. So these two loops are touching loops only. There is no possible of any non-touching loops here. Right? So therefore the transfer function is P1 delta 1 by 1 minus sum of all loops. Plus the third summation will not occur here because all the are touching loops only. So there is no possible in the denominator for other terms. So if you substitute the values 1 by 1 plus S plus 1 by S because L1, L2 summation will give a minus symbol. Already we have minus in the formula. So it will produce plus. So S plus 1 by S. If you simplify this, you will get S by S square plus S plus 1. That means the answer will be D. The next question is from PGSET 2015 paper. What is the question here? We need to find out the closed loop transfer function of unity feedback system with G1, G2 in the forward path. That means both the G1 and G2 are in the same forward path only. So overall transfer function of forward path is G of S is nothing but G1 into G2 because both are connected in the forward path. So overall G of S, that is forward path gain, G of S is nothing but product of G1 and G2. What is the question here? We need to find out the transfer function. We already know G of S is nothing but product of G1 and G2 and H of S is nothing but 1. So directly we can apply the basic formula of a closed loop feedback system, that is G of S by 1 plus G of S H of S. H of S value is 1, G of S is nothing but product of these two. To simplify this, we get the overall transfer function. This is the basic method. One more method is also there. It is, you can apply this method within a short span of time. You can quickly get the answers also. This is a very, very important method because a lot of problems have occurred in the competitive papers based upon this concept. They are already given the open loop system. We need to find out a closed loop transfer function. They are already given open loop transfer function. We need to find out a closed loop transfer function. Otherwise, they already mentioned the closed loop transfer function. From that, we have to find out the open loop transfer. These types of questions based upon this concept in the previous competitive exam. Okay? But only thing we should remember here is one of the important points for this concept is the closed loop system is a unity feedback. If you recollect every time the given system is a unity feedback system or not. That means H of S value is 1 or not. Then only this logic will applicable. Otherwise, it will not applicable. Okay. So the master should there will be a unity feedback, then the logic will applicable. If you see the look at the transfer functions of open loop and closed loop transfer functions. Open loop transfer function is G of S here. Closed loop transfer function is G of S by 1 plus G of S. Right? These are the transfer functions. For example, in the question, they already mentioned the open loop transfer function. That means they already given the open loop transfer function G of S. What we need to find out is a closed loop transfer function. That means G of S is, should be converted as this form. Okay, closed loop form. What we will do is G of S will be the same and the denominator I am doing is I am adding the same numerator part with the denominator 1 plus G of S. Understand? For obtaining closed loop system from the open loop, what I am doing is in the denominator, I am adding a numerator G of S value with 1 plus, that is 1 plus G of S I am adding here. Then I will get the closed loop transfer function. Similarly, in the question, they already mentioned a closed loop transfer function. We need to find out open loop. That means from this expression, I have to get G of S. What we will do means just directly subtract the numerator part from the denominator. Subtract the numerator part from the denominator. In the denominator, we will get 1 plus G of S minus G of S. That means we will get denominator part as 1. That means the answer will be G of S. That is the shortcut here. For obtaining open loop transfer function, for obtaining open loop transfer function means the question already mentioned the closed loop transfer function. For obtaining open loop transfer function, in the denominator, we have to subtract the numerator part. Similarly, for obtaining a closed loop transfer function, you should add the numerator part in the denominator. You should add the numerator part in the denominator, right? example, if you consider general expression, the open loop transfer function is already given A by B. Then what we need to find out is closed loop. For finding closed loop, what we will do is numerator part should add. Numerator part should add to the denominator. That is the concept. That means A by B, numerator part is A. You should add this A to the denominator. Then you get A by A plus B. A by A plus B. Understand? Otherwise, you can cross check with the formula also. Closed loop unity feedback formula is G of S by 1 plus G of S. So by substituting this one also, you will get the same thing. A by A plus B. But you should recollect the shortcut here. To obtain a closed loop system, what I am doing is numerator part is adding to the denominator. Right? Similarly, if I want a open loop, like given question, if you see the closed loop transfer function is the same transfer function A by A plus B. I want an open loop. I want an open loop means what I will do is I have to subtract the numerator part from the denominator. That means A value should minus from the denominator. So A plus B minus A will produce A by B. So this is a shortcut here. To obtain a closed loop system, you should add the numerator part in the denominator. For obtaining an open loop system, you should subtract the numerator part in the denominator. So addition is for closed loop transfer function, subtraction is for open loop transfer function. Let us consider the examples here. First example, what we need to find out is, we need to find out the closed loop transfer function of a given system. G of S value is 10 by S plus. G of S is nothing but 10 by S plus 1. If we consider only G of S, that means it is an open loop system. The question will be directly, they already given open loop system, we have to find out closed loop. They already given open loop, we need to find out closed loop. Because G of S only is considered as an open loop system. G of S only is considered as an open loop system without any feedback. This open loop system. So G of S is given. Open loop system is given. We have to find out closed loop. What is the shortcut here? For finding closed loop, we have to add the numerator part to the denominator. We have to add the numerator part to the denominator. That means the 10 should be added in the denominator. S plus 1 plus 10, we will get 10 by S plus 1. Within a short span, we will get the answer. Otherwise, you can cross check with basic formula. Here, h of s is 1. So, the overall formula is g of s by 1 plus g of s h of s. H of s value is 1 already. So, replace this g of s with 10 by s plus 1. We will get the same thing, 10 by s plus 11. So, I think this will be really clear to you. For finding closed loop, you should add the numerator part to the denominator. For finding open loop, you should subtract the numerator part from the denominator. One more example, this is a general expression, that is a g of s. In the question, they already given g of s, h of s is 1, g of s is omega n square by s into s plus 2 zeta omega n. Zeta or delta, we can say this is a damping factor, delta or I can mention zeta also, they already mentioned. That means open loop system, open loop gain is already given. What we need to find out is overall gain or closed loop transfer function gain. What is the shortcut here? Just we need to add the numerator part to the denominator. Then we will get the closed loop system. That means omega n square should add to the denominator. Then the answer will be omega n square by s square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square. This is the standard form representation of second order system. Lot of questions are framed based upon the standard form representation. Omega n is natural frequency, omega d is nothing but damping frequency. So omega d is equal to omega n into square root of 1 minus zeta square. Omega n is nothing but natural frequency. So these are the parameters we will see in the upcoming lectures. We will see the time standard form representations of this system and examples also. Okay. Otherwise, you can cross check the same problem with the basic formula g of s by 1 plus g of s. We will get the same thing. For obtaining a closed loop system, you should add a numerator part to the denominator. To get a open loop system, you should subtract the numerator part from the denominator. Okay, let us move on to our question. What is our question? Is PGCET paper 2015 question. What is the question here? So they already mentioned g1 of s, g2 of s. This is the question. g1 of s and g2 of s. They already mentioned k by s, r by r, c s plus 1. So overall g of s forward path gain is nothing but product of these two. That is kr by s into r c s plus 1. So this is the open loop transfer function. They already mentioned open loop transfer function. What we need to find out is closed loop transfer function. For finding closed loop transfer function, add this numerator part. Kr value should add to the denominator. So kr by RC S square plus S plus KR. So this is the closed loop transfer function for the given system. So I already mentioned the open loop system. So find out the closed loop. So for finding closed loop, just add the numerator part to the denominator. The answer will be option D for this question. Move on to the next question. This is a direct PD question from KGC paper, Tripoli 2018 paper. SFG, signal flow graph, is to find. What is the use of signal flow graph? Signal flow graph is only applicable to find the transfer function of the system. It is only applicable to find the transfer function of the system. It is not used to find the stability. Stability will be find out by using RH criteria, or you can by use root locus diagram, or by using border plot and Nyquist plot. All the frequency responses are also used to find the stability concept, but SFG is only used to find the transfer function. Controllability of the system is identified by using system matrix. System matrix, that is ABCD matrix, when the concept of state space analysis, you can easily identify the controllability of the system and also observability of the system also. So SFG is not used to find the controllability of the system. It is only applicable to find the transfer function of the system. What about the poles of the system? SFG is not used to find the poles of the system. It is just used to find the transfer function. Directly it will find the transfer function. So option C is the correct for this one. And the next question is from the green box. What is the green box? Green box is nothing but IUS paper. IUS paper 2007 to be. What is the question here is? This is the system they already mentioned. What we need to find out is transfer function. Is it easy to apply by using a block diagram? Somewhat confusion, right? So redraw the block diagram again. Then we can understand and we can apply the block diagram protection rules. Otherwise, we can apply SFG. So SFG is very simple concept. That's why I'm mentioning from the previous lecture onwards. So familiar with the SFG concept, you can solve any type of question which may be in block diagram representation or maybe in SFG representation. Just remember that SFG concept means Mason's game formula, which is used to find out the transfer function. We are using this concept only to find out the transfer function, not more than that. Okay. So for this question, SFG concept. We will apply SFG concept. Why can't we apply SFG? So we can apply SFG concept to solve this problem. Let us see how to apply this SFG concept. For this question, this is the method of solution we are obtaining here. First, we need to identify the forward path. The forward path is, it starts from input node to output node without any repeated nodes. So, R of S first forward path is directly it will reach us to the output node with a gain value 1, because there is no gain value mentioned here. So, from R of S to C of S, gain value is P1. And now, what about the second forward path means? The R of S, it starts from R of S and reaches through 1 by S. S power minus 1 is nothing but 1 by S. And again from the 1 by minus s, so 1 by s, it reaches to gain value a and reaches to the summing point and to output. So second forward path is p2 with a gain value. This is the gain value path so a by s, because here s power minus 1 is nothing but 1 by s. So a by s is nothing but the second forward path. If you look at this block diagram, we have only one loop, because we have only one feedback. The signal which came to the error signal is only one, okay. And also we have two forward paths. Let us check the closed loops here. From the input side summing point, the signal starts from here and reaches to S power minus 1. And again, it comes back to input error detector with a signal of minus here. So what is the gain value of L1 here? L1 is nothing but B by minus B by S. Why it is minus means? The feedback is minus negative area. That's why you should consider here minus B by S. The feedback is minus B by S. So this is the loop here. Is there any other possible of loops? I think there is no other possible of loop. Trace like this R of S to summing point and reaches to S power minus 1. Passes through A, go back to the output. So there is no possible loops other than this. So we have only one loop possible in the given block diagram. So L1 value is minus B by 2. L1 value is minus B by S. L1 value is minus B by S. So this loop is touching both the forward paths. This loop, L1 loop is touching both the first forward path and second forward path. So what about the delta 1 and delta 2 values? Both are 1. Because this loop is touching to the both first and second forward path. That's why delta 1 is 1 and delta 2 is also 1. What about the delta? delta is nothing but 1 minus sum of r loops. We have only one loop, so 1 minus L1. There is no touching loops here. We have only one loop. So then the formula for transfer function is P1 delta 1 plus P2 delta 2 by 1 minus L1. Therefore, if you substitute these ones, so the P1 delta 1 is 1 plus P2 delta 2 is A by S by L1 is already negative. We already have a negative in the formula. So plus B by 2. If you simplify this one, we will get S plus A by S plus B. So B is the answer for this IES paper 2007. The next question is from IES 2007 paper only. What is the question? So we need to find out the transfer function for the given block diagram. This can be simplified by using a block diagram reduction rules also, or you can try by using SFG. If you practice more number of problems based upon the SFG applications, then we can clearly understand and we can quickly answer the questions. Within a short span of time, we will get the transfer function also. By looking at this block diagram, we can directly write the transfer function. All the numerator part consists of G1, G2, G1, G2. That means A and B have same numerator part, and C and D has H1, G1, G2. H1, G1, B. That means numerator part of C and D are same, A and B are same. Forward paths, maximum numerator part will come from the forward paths by identifying the forward paths. In a given block diagram, first identify the number of forward paths and then identify the number of loops and write the gain values and substitute in the Mason's gain formula and cross-check the answers. Okay, and cross-check the options here. I think we can solve this problem. We can easily solve this problem. I am leaving this one to you, try it with SFG and let me know the answers in the comment box. That means the option A or B or C or D is the correct answer for this question. I hope you can understand each SFG concept. That's why I am leaving this question to you. I'll try to solve with SFG and let me know the answers in the comment box. The next upcoming lectures, we will discuss some of the problems from the GATE and IES papers, GATE paper and other computer exam papers based upon the same concept, SFG concept only. And also we'll see some of the block diagram concept, basic concepts. How to reduce the series block, how to reduce the parallel block, how to shift the takeoff point and summing points. Like the rules are there. We'll discuss the next lecture. Some of the basic concepts from the block diagram also. Lot of questions are framed on the basic block diagram rules also. That's why you should learn the fundamentals of the basic block diagram. But if the question is given in the transfer function, then blindly you can apply SFG. No need to bother about the block diagram rules. I hope this lecture will be very useful to you. I think this will be clear to you in the next upcoming lecture. We will move on to the block diagram basic fundamental concepts and also some of the problems from the GATE questions and other competitive exam papers also. Thank you. Thank you everyone. And don't forget to subscribe my channel and share and like my videos. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.